Ezekiel chapter 22, verse 30.
And I sought for anyone among them who would repair the wall and stand in the breach before me on behalf of the land, so that I would not destroy it, but I found no one.
Praise Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
To the prophet Ezekiel, the Lord says, rather, it is a lament, that the Lord was looking out for someone who would stand between the nation and God and intercede so that God may not destroy the nation. So God expects all of us, you and me, every baptized Christian, to become intercessors between our nation and between God. We have to take a stand. Between our country and God, we have to take a place. Between the church and God, we have to take place of an intercessor. Between the people who are condemned to death, people who are living a sinful life, we become the intercessor. That is what Ezekiel is asking. I am looking out for someone who would repair the wall and stand there interceding for the people so that I may not destroy the nation. I found none. So as you are listening to this message, commit yourself to be intercessors, because Jesus is an intercessor. He intercedes for humankind with the Father. And we are Christians. We proclaim Jesus as our Lord and Savior. And by baptism, each one of us should become an intercessor. So intercession is a very beautiful ministry in the church. Every Christian ought to intercede for others, for the church, for the world, for the sinners, and for the future. Hallelujah.
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 When you intercede for others, for your neighbor, Jesus is very much pleased with that. He will bless your neighbor because you are interceding for the others. Because the greatest commandment of Jesus is you love one another as I have loved you. Again he says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. So if you love your neighbor and pray for your neighbor, Jesus will be pleased with that. He will bless you as well as your neighbor. So become intercessors. Let your prayer time, part of your prayer time, be given for intercession, so that you will be blessed by the Lord. Also you will become saviors and you will inherit eternal life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 My dear friends, never ask any human persons or idols or even Satan to intercede for you. Never ever ask the dead people to pray for you. What happens after the death? When a human person dies, two things happen. Judgment takes place. If the person has lived a holy life, he goes to heaven. If he has lived a sinful life, he goes to hell. The chapter is over. The holy persons going to heaven, what happens to them there? They are in eternal joy, seeing God face to face with the angels, with saints, with the 24 elders, four living creatures, all the time praising and worshipping God. They don't look down upon people in the world to see what is happening. They don't listen to the prayers we are addressing towards them. This is the truth. Their lifetime, their mission is over. After death, their only thing, job, is praising and worshipping God for all eternity. They cannot make intercession. Same way, angels, they watch over us, but they cannot make intercession. Their job is to worship and adore God. Also, you don't think that you can pray to the devil. He may cheat you because he is a liar. He is a murderer. From the beginning, he is cheating the people. He is leading people astray to be away from God. So never pray to Satan. Also, never pray to any idols. The idols have no ears, no mouth, no eyes. They cannot speak. They cannot bless you. They cannot intercede with the Father for you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Rather, while we are living on earth, let us pray for each other. Let us pray for the world. Let us pray for the sinners. Jesus will surely hear our prayer and bless us and bless all those for whom we are praying. Hallelujah.
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 Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 4.
Go through the city, through Jerusalem, and put a mark on the foreheads of those who sigh and groan over all the abominations that are committed in it.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
How many of you want to go to heaven?
Everyone.
All. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What you should do is given here. There, it is a vision given to Ezekiel. There, the Lord God is seated on the throne and there are angels on either side. One side, angels are going to put a mark. Another side, angels are standing with weapons to kill people. The Lord God says to one side of angels, if you are reading the next verses in that chapter, beautiful it is, the 9th chapter of Ezekiel. The Lord says, you go and look for people who sigh and mourn over all the abominations committed by the people in Jerusalem. When you find anyone praying for people and weeping and making reparation for the sins committed by the Israel people, on their foreheads you put a stamp, you put a seal, the Lord says. The next verse will come after 5th and 6th. The other people, you follow them. You go, start from the sanctuary, murder every one of them, cut them down without mercy, young and old, men and women, everybody who do not bear the mark or seal, the Lord is saying. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And dear brothers and sisters, who learn this secret, if you want to go to heaven, become intercessors. The Lord will put a stamp, a seal on you. That is a guarantee for you to reach heaven. If you do not pray for sinners, if you do not pray for your country, if you do not pray for your church, if you do not pray for your family even, if you do not pray for the poor, the sick and the suffering, you will not have the mark. Rather, you will be condemned to be killed, murdered. That is what Ezekiel says. So, while you are living, become intercessors. Jesus himself is an intercessor. The Holy Spirit is an intercessor. Be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and pray. And intercede for others. Make intercession for others. You will receive the mark, and that mark will be counted there. It will be like giving you a passport or a visa to enter heaven. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 As you are listening to this message, I appeal to you. Once you are convinced about this truth that Jesus is Lord, he is the mediator, he is the intercessor, he is inviting you to become intercessor, become prayer warriors. That is a big mission. Never neglect your prayer. Let your prayer time be filled with praise and worship, and good portion of the time should be spent for intercession. The more you intercede for others, the more you will be blessed. The more you call upon blessing for people, the more blessings will be turned towards you. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah.